individual skill of each member of Saint and explains why bands could be potentially targeted. Think about the champions that are left remaining, however, available on the board with this.
Nubia are actually going to take Caitlyn off the board there. They target that one towards STYZ, although Caitlyn, you know, has been coming back into the meta quite a lot since MSI. That was one of STYZ's famous champions, and it's in fact the champion that he used fantastically to get their only victory against IG.
I was going
to
say, they've won one game and it was with the Caitlyn, so banning that one away is definitely targeted STYZ. Saint with 4 seconds left, could choose between Vlad or Swain. Realistically, pick neither. We'll see what they go for.
They're going to actually ban out Sivir here, so they don't want that AD carry to be taken to the roof today, which means, you know, Vlad, Swain left up, Kindred left available as well.
Yeah, Kindred probably the prime choice given that Nidalee's not there yet. The Rek'Sai always feels like it's a prevalent member in that jungle role. And a question of preference now for Nubia. Swift has always been a fantastic Rek'Sai player. Mm-hmm. Most importantly, I think we need to touch on the fact that there are 380 carry bans. Ezreal still standing. Probably just want to lock that one away.
Potentially. Normally we see Ezreal taken into the very... taken into the Lucian matchup when he is normally taken as one of the priority picks in the bottom lane. That's been banned out here today. Nubia taking a lot of time with deciding what they're going to pick up as their first pick here. Mentioned, you know, lots of very strong picks. This is one of them. Vladimir being hovered on your screen right now. And wouldn't be too surprised to lock it in, but they've got a lot to play with. And if they lock in this power pick, Saint can respond with two power picks of their own, as they do lock in the Vladimir.
Yeah, delicate balance between target bans and strong meta picks, as whilst they lock in that Vladimir, we can touch on what Saint now look towards on the other side. Knowing that the mid lane options are definitely there. Mm-hmm. The other AD carry that we touched upon as well, Ezreal, remaining as probably the only S tier AD carry left in the champion pool.
And this is still 6.10, so no major changes coming out to Azir, which is one of them that's being hovered now. His ultimate still has a very long duration, as Ezreal is going to be locked in as the AD carry of choice for Saint. That's going to be played by STYZ today. Wait to see what they're going to lock in next. Like we mentioned earlier, you know, Azir, Victor, the two control mages in the mid lane are still left up and available. Swain's left up as well. So is the Kindred. Lots of powerful picks for these teams to pick around and to play with here in the Champions League draft.
Yeah. They should be locking that one in, yeah.
And they do. Swain's going to be locked in for Saint.
I was going to be surprised if they didn't. Most importantly, you would be then giving over a Vladimir and a Swain in a single team composition. And they could then cater the rest of their team comp to complement what was going to be a lot of magic damage and strength. Mm-hmm. I still expect the Kindred to be seen, and the preference for Dade between Azir and Victor, I would imagine the Azir, dependent on whether the Vladimir is top or mid, though. We know that V has an exceptional Swain. I would imagine Vladimir is no exception to that rule.
Still lots of junglers to play with from both these teams, so, you know, Kindred, Rek'Sai, Graves. Few of those that are up there, and we also see the Gragas and Lee Sin come out when there's heavy bans targeted towards the junglers in the LPL. We're going to have to wait and see what Nubia decides to pick out here. This has been a very slow champion select coming out from these two teams, thinking very long and hard about what they want to play in this match. And it does seem like Nubia are content with picking up the Kindred and Braum during their second pick rotation.
Yeah, so locking that one away secures themselves a very rarely dying team composition right now. I think the quick flash of the Jhin also aligned themselves with where they actually wanted to finish their draft as. Could have been seen as a slight error from Nubia, dependent on what they actually lock in. Almost a sign of revealing your hand before you actually show.
I'm still waiting for Saint to lock in their next few picks. They're missing a mid laner jungler and a support right now, unless they flex the Swain into the mid lane. Commonly see teams take him up towards the top side of the map.
We've seen a rising in mid lane Swain comparatively to that of the top lane. Also knowing there's a Vladimir that can do either as well kind of leaves you open for options. But Saint being on the red side, having that last pick available, they can actually just let Nubia show their hand.
We'll get to see what they do with that last pick, but for now still looking at their next two, as Rek'Sai is going to be the jungler of choice being locked in here by Saint's lineup. So Marsh going to bring that into the jungle, as Bard is going to be their supportive choice being taken onto the Rift.
Rek'Sai and Bard. Very hard to kill any member of Saint at the moment. Ezreal, perfect amount of disengage, can poke and kite people around. Bard did Zach same. And Swain and Rek'Sai, needless to say, they're not going to have a fun time trying to kill them on the side of Newbie.
You look at Newbie's side, I've got a Vladimir Kindred Broom. I don't think anyone's going to have a fun time dying in this game.
But it also means they want to clash with each other endlessly. And Vladimir and a Swain sitting in a side lane does not sound like a tea party.
No. It sounds like a farm fiesta.
It does.
Still waiting for Newbie to round out their team composition here. They're going to go with one more of their solo laners, as Vladimir can definitely flex that. And possibly their AD carrier choice. You did mention earlier they flashed the Jhin, so that could definitely be their champion of choice. And it is going to be locked in here for Newbie's lineup. Happy's going to be playing that one today. Still waiting to see what the final pick would be. And it does look like it's going to be a Fizz, which should be going up into the top lane, I believe.
Yeah, you would have to imagine at first glance that the Fizz will be the top laner.
Mm-hmm.
With the Vlad going mid, and now the choice is there for Saint. Do they want the Swain against the mid laner of the Vladimir, or the top laner of the Fizz? Now, realistically, you'd say you don't want to be against the Fizz simply because you'll probably run Ignite. You'll have a great time running around, just killing everybody that tries to heal. You'd want it to be against the Vlad, but we've actually seen, not necessarily historically, but recently, the Vladimir winning that 1v1.
We'll have to see if that's going to be the matchup being taken place. For now, though, Saints still looking to pick up their final pick here. These two teams just waiting for the final seconds. No draft phase to tick down before locking in anything, and it is going to be the Echo pickup. This is still a flex pick from this team. It could be mid lane, it could be top lane. You've seen it played across the scene in multiple roles now. But it is going to be the Fizz up in the top lane. We can already see the Ignite and Teleport being taken by V. He's looking to try and kill whoever he's facing off against on the Rift today.
Yeah, summoner spells usually tell this story as well.
Mm-hmm.
Ghost, of course, being there for Dade earlier. He's playing the Vladimir. Very hyped, Dade. Great Vladimir player. Snoopy, though, having the Teleport edge, could actually indicate a slight benefit to Snaint once they hit that middle game stages with their team composition. So have a look at the final drafts.
And we are gonna be able to see the Vladimir against Swain match into the mid lane, which is where these two champions have been moving towards more recently, away from the top lane, as that's going to be Fizz taking on the Echo. We have the Kindred against Rek'Sai in the jungle, and these two bottom laners look like they want to fight quite a bit here in the bottom lane.
Yeah. It's definitely going to be a fighting heavy bottom, mid, jungle to an extent, and even the fervor of battle top lane. They'll be stacking that up very quickly and destroying each other's health bars. Could be a pretty heavy hitting game one.
Well, let's see how this goes out as we head into the Summoner's Rift for game number one. To the Rift for game number one between Newbie and Saint here. Everyone has loaded up and are heading across the Rift. Possibly, you know, gonna fan out, scan out for vision right off the start. We don't see anything too cheeky coming out from these teams so far.
We're just having a tour of the Rift. It's fantastic, actually.
Sights and sounds of Summoner's Rift right as we start this game.
Yeah, so we are gonna see that mid lane matchup we alluded towards that we also said Vladimir has a great time in. That's interesting.
He's going to be taking Storm Raider's Surge here on the Vladimir in the mid lane. We see a lot of Strength of the Ages being picked up for Vladimir's.
Pretty curious that he'd go for that. Understandably, Vladimir does a lot of bursts, so 30% of someone's health bar makes you pretty fast. But he has the Ghost, so I guess it's doubling up on move speed almost needlessly. He's just got a lot of mobility.
You ignore a lot of slow as well when that Storm Raider Surge pops.
I mean, like, you've already got the Ghost, though, again. Like, you're just doubling up to be super fast. So you look at who he's trying to catch, perhaps, or run away from. Makes sense that you want to dodge the Swain's never move. Perhaps get on top of the Ezreal, who'll be slowing you down all the time. Bard has slows. Echo has slows. Like, it's by no means bad. I'm just curious that he's opting towards the the catch and pick maneuver, not so much the sustainer tankiness, as they've found you.
Sue actually going to face check here. Brom and Happy going to get a lot of damage down on towards this bard. Forces Sue to actually flash away. Morzzy B takes a lot of damage in return, but does not have to blow his flash. Only uses the exhaust there.
All things considered, they're both going to be supports with potions, so nobody actually comes out directly ahead.
Mm-hmm.
Sue will start to have shrines that'll heal everybody back up to full, and there's a relic shield on the side of Moore for some health back himself.
It also means we're going to see the two teams swap the AD carries and supports up to the top side of the map. So Australia lane's coming out here in game number one between Newbie and Saint. And again, they're being aggressive. That's a flash forward on top of Shield. They lock him down with the Bard stun. Jin puts a lot of auto attack damage down. Bard actually taking damage in return. He's been ignited, trying to run away.
No.
They're not able to pick up the kill on towards Shield. Saint able to pick up two kills up in the top lane here. Happy is going to go down as well. STYZ is going to pick that one up. And a huge advantage for Saint right off the bat.
Cool guys don't look at explosions does not actually work when there is no explosion to see. Sue actually leveling up on the back of that first blood is enough to keep him alive. And just an absolute disaster, honestly, this early in the game for Newbie. Inexcusably aggressive from this team that we expect to be favorites coming into this. Now on the back foot through that duo lane.
Mm-hmm.
3 CS is what Jin has right now, focusing on kills more than anything else. Swift has a big wave to catch at the very least.
He's not even going to be able to do it.
He gives it over.
And that roof scuttle was taken away by Rek'Sai as well, so can't even pick that one up. Luckily not spotted out by the vision, but still, you know, this is the lane that we look at for Saint to do well. When they have STYZ in the AD carry and support lane, that's the lane you always want to look at for Saint to do well, and they always manage to get ahead somehow. Now the question is if they can snowball that advantage later on in the game. Marsh is going to try and get a gank off towards Veek. Parallel Convergence comes out. Doesn't lock him down for the stun.
Flash.
He doesn't have stun. Took Ignite to the Rift instead. He's going to get locked down. But a flash actually will come out from Akon. He will still be able to pick up a kill on towards the top laner.
Yeah, having the jungler there from Saint once again picks up that kill. Fizz does not run flash. It's always Ignite as the summoner spell of choice.
Mm-hmm.
Didn't really have a way to get out. So instead opted towards the kill. Not going to find it, because guess what? Akon definitely does run it.
And already a great start for Saint here on Summoner's Rift. They're more than 1,000 gold ahead of Newbie just 4 minutes into this game. And looking really impressive. I did not expect this from them in game one.
I don't think anybody expected this, plain and simple. We came into the first week of the LPL and said that Newbie were the second best team in their group. And the team that is currently last is now ahead of them by 1,000 gold at 4 minutes. In game number one.
This is a team that not only is coming last, but was expected to come last here in the LPL. No high expectations for the Saint lineup in there. Proving us wrong here this early into the game. We have to see if they can continue to do just that as we progress towards the mid and later stages of the game. For now though, March is going to be taking away his own blue buff after getting the successful gank on towards Akon in the bottom lane. Haven't seen too much of Swift just yet. He's been farming it out. His level 4 doesn't have any buffs at the moment. It's making his way towards V's lane now, trying to do something.
I mean, farming's still definitely fine for a Kindred in the jungle. Farms well and wants to scale with items. Problem being, Kindred is still a good ganking jungler, and March has been excelling at that even comparatively. One is still infinitely better than zero, doing the numbers. I feel like this is not really an opportunity that the Kindred wants to gank. It's more of an opportunity that he thinks he's counter-ganking. We'll see how this one plays out, because Akon does enjoy a good fight.
Well, you can already see V trying to force the fight here against Akon. Akon just doesn't want
Well, he doesn't have March nearby. He's currently at the Krugs.
He's at top side of the map. Just took his blue, red buff away. Now working towards his Krugs. As we take a look towards the mid lane, actually. Swain getting the upper hand slightly against Vladimir at the moment. Here comes Bard for a roam down. Slaps with the meats. Misses the stun, though. Not going to be able to lock him down with another move either, as the Ghost was popped there by Dade.
Yeah, so popping the Ghost is handy. You have to remember it's the lower cooldown summoner spell of the two, between Ghost and Flash. Swift is finally in.
Well, they're trying to get the jump on towards Akon. Going to be able to slow him down. Power Convergence is not going to be able to save his life. V is able to pick up a kill after a very patient gank coming out from Swift.
I was going to say, about a minute and a half later, actually find themselves the kill. Swift was definitely patient. V did not alter his playstyle. He was aggressive from start to finish there. And that's a big lead, actually, secured by this Fizz. If we look at the solo laner's farm, And now that there's a kill on board with that as well, that's actually just grown back to a massive lead from almost even. Mid lane also, I will say the Vladimir, as expected, is putting in some work onto that Swain.
Mm-hmm.
Things even out okay.
Quite ahead in terms of farm right now. 15 CS up. Ahead of Snoopy at the moment.
Yeah. And so things do actually even out to an okay middle point. As here we go again. Level 6 Swain.
Turns on his bird form and just runs at people. Dade does not want anything to do with that Swain at the moment.
No, he needs to get a shop in firstly. So, I mean, the end result of all of this early laning is that Saint is still ahead in gold in a situation where realistically they shouldn't have been. Mm-hmm. Just a big mistake mechanically from the 2v2 of Happy and Moore. Something that you do not expect from what is a really good duo lane.
You know, Happy, previously known as Pekko, known to be one of those safer laners. Not that aggressive early on the game, known for his late game team fighting. Well, turns on the aggression very early, and NCYZ made him pay for that one. They're still opting to stay up in the top lane, both the Saint and newbie lineup, content with having their duo lane fighting it out up top. For now, though, March looking to try and invade towards newbie side of the jungle. He does have the duo lane here with him, and they're going to be able to contest for this blue buff. Doesn't seem like newbie going to be able to stop them in any way.
Find Swift as well. No, they don't want to fight him.
Nope.
There you go. Very well executed and timed on the steal of that blue buff.
Mm-hmm.
Swift wasn't too far away, and he wasn't exactly slow to it either.
You can only look at the CS advantage that March has created for himself at the moment. He's about 20 CS ahead of Swift right now, contributing to the gold lead that Saint have.
Remember that a lot of the time that Swift wasted in the bottom lane, March was farming. I won't say wasted outright. These two. It's funny because it looks high impact, you know? Swain's just like doing all of his buttons, and then Vladimir actually just gets up his Crimson Rush bar and heals it all back. And you're like, oh, right. Makes sense. I've spotted Swift.
It is the battle of mid laners who refuse to die.
Well, the meta's definitely shifting in that direction, isn't it?
Yep. Won't be long till we see Aatrox and Zac come back.
I really don't hope you.
See, I'm actually going to see a steal coming in there. March able to take that one away, I believe. Swift tries to battle with the Rek'Sai, but he's content with taking him on. Now here comes Moore, trying to get a jump on towards March. He's going to get stunned and slowed there. Going to desperately try and run away. Shield now joining the fight. The rest of the team is looking to try and start a fight here for the side of the Saint lineup.
Whoa.
They actually want to brawl it out here as Akon and V are also going to battle out towards the bottom side of the river. But, you know, they're just chunk each other down and run away.
Really early rotation from this bottom lane of Saint. I feel like they've bought themselves a giant lead. They've established that lead. And then they start to throw it away by wanting to lane swap. Their advantage was not big enough that they can outright take any turrets.
Mm-hmm.
They didn't have the Rek'Sai as a threat to dive the bottom lane. Very unusual circumstances have put them towards the bottom side of the map where realistically they're getting nothing for this. They're just hiding themselves. And that's unusual. It's a full mana immune purchase. And they were, in a way, hiding themselves. You can tell that newbie want the standard 2v2.
Yep, they're actually going to swap their AD carry and support down towards the bottom lane. So it seems like, you know, Saint wanted the lane swap. Newbie wanted to match them. They found that blind match. And now opting to just follow them around the rest of the rift. Saint still do have a slight CS lead in the bottom lane. But more importantly, like you mentioned, the kill that went over to STYZ, giving them an early edge. We'll have to see if they are going to throw it away here by going back in towards the 2v2 one more time.
And you know, funnily enough, whilst it was an unusual decision, it was timed very well. They got a lot of damage under that turret for no response available on the side of newbie. So with nothing doing, they at the very least chip away at the structure, set themselves up for a future push. It is kind of just future-proofing themselves by moving around the map.
Meanwhile, we're going to take a look at March here in his jungle. Takes away another buff for himself, this time clearing out his own red buff. After the initial early brawls we saw between these two teams, things have gotten a little bit more quiet now. You have to think, you know, both these teams very comfortable with prolonging the laning phase. Saint, you know, from the LSPL, a lot of players from the LSPL love to have elongated laning phases. Singlish is difficult. Newbie also, previously from the LSPL, quite some time ago though. Very fond of those prolonged and extended laning phases. And Zardin now actually go toe-to-toe here against Snoopy. Doesn't have his bird phone up and available. Teleport actually going to be coming in towards the mid laner's Acorn, trying to get down here and stop the fight. Teleport actually used by V and immediately cancelled as well.
Just letting him know that his presence is definitely worthy of a teleport.
I am here.
Yeah.
I remember me.
This is me in your bottom lane. Could have used that teleport, but I am available. Unfortunately, not anymore.
Saint are going to be able to pick up an early turret for themselves. The 2-on-2 bottom lane able to...
Maybe a Drake.
Shove Happier more away. Yes. Saint actually looking towards taking down the first dragon of the game, which is going to be a Cloud Dragon in about 12 minutes.
Yeah, so when we discussed future-proofing, that's exactly what it means. Chip away at that bottom turret, actually get it to a low health value, immediately send your jungler in and rotate, and see if you can actually get it down. So the turret falls, the Drake falls. Teleport's actually burned by the top laner of V, so they can't rotate for a full-on fight.
Yep.
Even the ultimate used by Dade in this middle lane means there was just nothing available for them.
And Snoopy still has his teleport up and available, so a slight global pressure advantage coming out from the Saints lineup. They're still ahead by 2,000 gold here at the moment, so putting in some work against Newbie this early into the game.
Yeah, they excel in the middle game just based off that double teleport composition also. Their early game's definitely still the strong point of them as a team, not necessarily the composition or the draft they put together. It still does its purpose. Newbie as well have always shown a weakness in the early game. So whilst this lead is 2,000, it's not a big surprise if we see Newbie come back into it. We do still need to see consolidation of Vice Saint here, recognizing that lead, establishing further, and actually stamping their foot on it.
We've seen this before as well. Newbie, previously Chalgru, more than happy to... Well, they wouldn't be very happy about it, but they
content.
Can fight from behind.
They're content.
Meanwhile, though, Saint's actually trying to pick a fight inside of Newbie's jungle. Marsh taking a lot of damage, trying to take that one away. There goes the Cursor Call, looking to try and find the Rek'Sai. Can't get the last shot off. And suddenly, Saint's have turned around a teamfight. They find a double kill on towards STYZ. They're looking for more. They can't find anyone else in the Newbie lineup. And that's a 2-for-nothing trade.
And Newbie just looks so out of sorts at the moment.
What's
March
going on?
Marsh is almost going to die. They get themselves the Rift Herald to back this one up, you would imagine. That was a team fight where Happy basically just spent the whole time trying to kill a Rek'Sai. Just playing a dodging and guessing game. Really unusual stuff here, honestly. Just outright confused.
Unfortunately, it does seem like we have a little bit of technical difficulties here from the Newbie lineup. Hopefully we can get them resolved as soon as possible and head back on towards the Rift. And we talked about Newbie. They've really been struggling so far in the summer split of the LPL. And they're proving it one more time here. They are struggling against Saint, what is considered to be one of the weakest teams in the LPL right now. And Saint really stepping up their game against Newbie today.
It's such a hard thing to say. Like, is Newbie stepping down or is Saint stepping up? Or are they both just like at this plateaued level where Saint are just having a better early game? You really can't tell, especially not this early into the game. But what we can say is this is not the Swift that we're used to seeing.
Nope.
This is not the Happy and more that we're used to seeing. Newbie just don't look the same, and it's a very worrying trend for them moving forward.
It certainly is, and Saints on the flip side have been looking pretty decent in this game. You know, they've been playing around with their mid laner and jungler quite a bit in the summer split here, you know, throwing in Otto in the mid lane, throwing March, Captain, and Chimin into the jungle at certain times. Now, March been throwing in there has had quite a huge impact early on in the game here. You know, we saw the early gank onto Akon. We see how he drew a lot of attention away from Happy with the curtain call, not able to take him down either.
Yeah.
Saints looking a little bit more comprehensive, you could say, early on in the game against Newbie.
Yeah, I think their proactivity is commendable. I think the way that Saints are actually playing the map right now is definitely an acceptable, if not at a high level of play. They know what they want to do. They're playing very cerebral League of Legends and thinking past what is happening at that exact moment, where they're going to be. They chip away at the bottom turret. They move their bottom lane to the actual bottom lane from top so they can pressure the dragon. But they actually pressure the turret, knowing that the Drake is there to take shortly afterwards. So they are playing a very solid style of League of Legends right now.
Mm-hmm.
But this isn't something that Saint have always lacked.
Yep.
I feel like they've always had an early game where the teams that they're playing against are always usually just better than them, and it ends up unfolding very quickly.
Especially during the laning phase. That's where we normally see Saints excel, you could say. That's where their bread and butter is, basically. They're able to take a lot of the best teams in the league head-to-head and during the early phase, but it's normally after that. Normally after the laning phase where they start to falter. But looking at the side of Newbie, Dade in the laning phase here, you know, he's been a little bit weaker in comparison to Doinbi, but this match here on Isvanami, he's been doing pretty well against Snoopy so far. Ahead in CS, you know, controlling him, so to speak, trading quite effectively as well. But it is Isvanami against Swain, you know. Nobody's really going to die in that lane, you'd hope.
Nobody's going to die, but the Vladimir usually has a slight edge. So what we are seeing is Dade winning a lane where you expect him to win. So thankfully, for Nubi, Dade has been doing his job, but the Swain's always going to be relevant as we move towards the mid stages. Once Swain hits six, maybe hits the mid game, you actually see Swain bring it back, and maybe it doesn't favor the Vladimir anymore, especially having a teleport edge on the side of Snoopy. Whereas Dade's going to have the ghost and can't actually sit in a side lane and impact the rest of the team if he were to be there. I think there's a lot of risks that Nubi are now about to run themselves into where Saint can actually excel.
So what else are we going to be looking towards as we move forward into this game? Because I wasn't able to check the goal lead that they had as we headed into that quick pause. But, you know, what can we expect from these two lineups? Because Nubi, you know, known to excel during team fights, Saint known to falter after the laning phase. Is this what's going to happen? Or Saint, you know, giving themselves enough of a lead to put up a good fight here against Nubi?
Well, I mean, based off what we've seen so far, there aren't a lot of neutral objectives left. I think the big question is how can Saint actually work around turret play and get themselves an actual gold value advantage? Right now, they've got the Drake, they've got the Rift Herald. They have taken the bottom turret, but mid isn't broken, top's not broken. There's still opportunities for Saint to grow that lead further or for Nubi to come back into the game. But really, we have to question how they execute now. Can they set up vision properly? Can they take down these objectives and turrets against what is a very resilient side on the side of Nubi?
I think another big thing that stands out to me as well, the fact that STYNC, yes, he is the star AD carry of the lineup. You know, lots of expectations coming out from STYNC in general for quite some time now. He's got most of the gold in his pocket. They're relying on this Ezreal to put in some work, and we've seen that kind of falter in the current meta when AD carries are the ones that try to carry the rest of the team or put the team on the back, so to speak. Doesn't quite work out because it feels like AD carries a little bit weaker at the moment. Is this what we're going to continue to see, especially against someone like Happy, who's known for his late game team fights on AD carries?
I think, you know what, the LPL is very different like this. Like, yes, AD carries are meant to be the facilitators with their support at the moment. Maybe Ashe, something that's seeing a lot more prevalence. Sivir as well bounces back. But The LPL is notorious for simply just having godlike AD carries. Like, imp playing Vayne, Uzi always wants to carry. I don't think there's any exception with STYZ. And yes, whilst we question what he's going to be able to do compared to perhaps a Vladimir or a Swain, which always stand out as like insanely strong champions, I think he will still be perfectly fine on this Ezreal. Will still scale and have enough utility with that Iceborne Gauntlet.
Well, we've seen Imp in the LPL try to 1v5 a couple of times. Yeah, let's see if STYZ can put on a performance where he tries to 1v5 and actually takes down the team when he does that. But we have headed back into the Rift. The technical difficulties have been resolved for now. Hopefully they'll be able to continue to stay that way as we can actually take stock of where this game is at the moment. There's a close to 4,000 gold lead for Saint 15 minutes into the game. I know they're strong in the laning phase, but this is unexpected from the Saint lineup against Nubi.
Unexpected is a very good way to describe what is happening right now on Summoner's Rift between these teams. The 5th and 6th place, I believe they are still in the standings teams.
Mm-hmm.
Nubi should be not 6th. They should not be 5th. They should probably be 2nd. Definitely out of sorts at the moment against the side that haven't really shown that they have what it takes to keep up with the best yet. This gold lead grows again and again. They're now nearing the 5k mark. They've broken that top lane. All that's left is the middle lane. Look at the vision they've set up before they took that turret.
Yep.
They just want to fight as well in an outright skirmish.
And we can actually take a look at where, as you know, they're just going to fight the mid lane here. Nothing too much is going to happen. Tade dodges the never move and then uses the proto belt to get even further away. But we can actually take a look at where all this gold has given advantage to the Saint lineup so far. We can already see Akorn on his Echo looking towards his Spirit Visage very early into the game here. Rek'Sai already picked up his Cinderhawk and the Sightstone as well, his Swifty. So, you know, core items of the Rek'Sai now. Swain already stacking the Rod of Ages, and Ezreal has his key item spikes at the moment. So Saints looking to try and end their laning phase, but bang, as they move towards the mid lane turret, and going to try and take this one down as well as Shu and STYZ putting some decent damage on towards
him. Nice done. That's a lot of damage.
A lot of damage down on towards Swift. He's not having a great game so far. 0-1-1 is, look at this, Dade.
Oh, Dade.
Being really aggressive. STYZ, though, is going to be able to take him down. Swift now dashing forward is going to be able to shut down STYZ on his Ezreal, but it's still a 1-for-1 trade.
Yeah, they end up getting that. Oh, Sue's actually very close to dying.
Curtain call is going to come out.
Snoopy's just going to stand still and be swaying. Yep. Like, just cancel your
resume. Get your cooldown back, my friend.
Doesn't want to either way. We're seeing another sign of aggressiveness now coming out of Saint. They're recognizing how far ahead they definitely are. And whilst it was a one for one, Dade, I was actually about to say, looks all sort of confused. He's being out-traded by Snoopy. Of course, the Swain hitting the mid-game stages brings back some strength into the Birds book. The end result is that they can actually put Swain into a side lane. They can have that Ezreal group, and they've now shown that they can capably at least fight the Vladimir, which means they'll need more people there. More will be drawn out to another lane. Happy will be left alone, potentially dove here and there by the opposite side. They're moving Newbie very effectively.
They did have a burn their teleport on towards Snoopy on the Swain, so might be a little bit more difficult for him to split push in the side lanes for the next 4 to 5 minutes. But they're still going to keep Dade in the mid lane for the side here of Newbie. Swift is still waiting just behind the Vladimir in case things go sour. This March, looking to try and deep invade and put some vision down for the Saints lineup. He's having a decent game so far. As there is that split push coming out from Snoopy, sitting down the sidelines, up against V, actually.
Yeah, and can fight V. Outright can fight him. He hasn't completed an item on the side of that Fizz, comparative to what the Swain definitely has in his back pocket, as well as complete map control on the bottom jungle by Saint, means that they can afford to be this aggressive, whether it works or not.
And they've got four people down in this bottom lane at the moment, looking to try and pressure the bot lane in a turret.
It's because Kadade can't rotate.
That's Acorn. He's going to be moving towards the mid lane on his Echo. Trying to keep up with the split push that Saint are dishing out. For now, they're going to look towards taking down another dragon. It's going to be second Cloud Dragon of the game, falling over towards the Saint lineup.
And two starts to add up. One, not impactful. Bard altered. That was not really synergy.
Lance towards Swift is going to get stunned down by Shu as well. Flashes forward. There's a flash from March as well, locking down Swift, knocking him up, but he's able to get the ultimate off in time. Still falls down to Snoopy after the ult wears off. He's going to get taken down though as Dade finds a kill for himself. Curtain Call is being popped there by Happy, looking to try to take someone down. It's not going to be able to do just that, but that's a double kill coming out for Dade.
Dade.
A triple's coming out. He wants more as he tries to chase down the remaining members of Saints, and suddenly Newbie able to find a team fight for themselves.
Yeah, they get themselves a big team fight. Actually, a mechanical error on the side of Saint. Not only was the Ezreal ultimate used at the same time as the Tempered Fate, so it didn't connect with anybody, they overcommit. The Swain goes deep to secure a single kill, fair enough. He has actually just gotten himself killed to do that. Maybe let him go. Mm-hmm. Just let it happen. They try and escape through the middle lane where that outer turret is still standing. And that's the big mistake. Because that's not safety. That's exactly where Dade wants to be. They brought the fight into the Vladimir's domain. And he ruined them for it.
Well, Saint still have the gold lead despite the fight going in favor of Newbie. There's still about 3,000 gold ahead. So they still have some wiggle room to work with against Newbie. That does mean a lot of pressure being alleviated from Newbie's side of the map. Swift now going to be able to take away his blue buff uncontested. Not going to have March sitting all up inside of his jungle trying to stop him from taking that one away.
We've always said that wiggle room is a very relative thing against certain teams, right? Newbie's always going to have a pretty strong late game regardless of how the gold has going, how the game has been played out. So you can't afford as much wiggle room against a side like that. You need to effectively close out leads. At this stage, Dragon is actually going to be quite big for Saint, though.
No, Newbie, they like the team with that starts with a Cole on everybody. They start with the same gold as you, but slowly they trickle
they
and trickle a little bit more in.
After now, 30 though, minutes, it gets unblocked. Get extra gold for free.
Kind of like Team WE as well. 35 minutes, the Elder Dragon team.
Absolutely. Different ways of winning the game, but definitely still late-game team fighters.
Mm-hmm. For now, though, Saint still in control of this match. I'm just being a little bit more cautious, you could say now. Taking things a little slower. Zade moves in on towards Seal, trying to get a little bit of damage down towards the bar. This turret taking a lot of damage from the Saint lineup. STYZ going to put some work down and chip it down as much as he possibly can. The rest of the Saint team is now grouped up towards this mid lane. We're having a little bit of an A-Ram right now. It's everybody on the map here in toward the mid lane, trying to protect this turret and trying to take it down
nice
and respond
shot
from Saint.
Is Saint wants the branch turret. Saint just really want the turret. And sooner or later, they'll probably get this turret. because it's dragging five members of Newbie here. So they will have to start sacking this eventually. Looks like potentially just now.
You know, Newbie don't have the best wave clears. They pop the Curtis Call trying to start a fight. That turret is going to fall down. Acorn goes deep. Use the ultimate to get away. Curtis Call
has a sick flank if they choose to fight this. That's why they back up.
Curtis Call was expended. Doesn't take anyone down. Like you mentioned, Dado did have the flank. Didn't use it. But another turret falls in Saint's favor. They're now 4,000 gold ahead of Newbie.
Yeah, bring it back to that 4K. Playing the map better than Newbie are. Forcing rotations is the saving grace once again of this Saint roster. If you can run them around, you will actually just confuse them into disarray and start taking objectives away from them. The only remaining outer has just been sacked, though, and unfortunately for our red team, it now becomes infinitely harder to get the next. It's a bigger time sink, bigger gold sink with wards, and how long you have to actually spend to get it, and it's a big commitment. So they need to make sure that this is correct. The next movement could actually decide if they win or lose this game.
Let's see what Saints' next movement's going to be. They've had control over all the major objectives so far. Baron is up on the playing field as well, so they possibly look towards taking that down. And they do have control over the Dragon Pit, which is going to respawn in 2 minutes. The third dragon of the game is going to be an Ocean Dragon, so not quite what you would want as Saint, but still a good thing to have. They still start to add up as you get deeper and deeper into the game.
Yeah, it's definitely still a nice to have. Remember that every dragon they get complements the Elder Dragon buff as well.
Yep.
So as this game continues to progress, they are still moving between strengths. But once again, we have to ask the question. Saint, we've only ever seen them win once. And we know that the first time we saw them win wasn't exactly a clean victory.
Nope.
Can they actually do it?
Yep, taking Invictus Gaming down to absolutely no turrets remaining and stay that way for a good 20 minutes as well as Invictus Gaming were fighting them with their bare Nexus and were still able to win those fights.
Very scrappy team though sometimes, IG. Mm-hmm. They do excel in random moments like that for some reason. You saw it in the last series, the Twisted Fate play.
And you know, same sentiments for Saint as well. They really feel like one of those scrappier teams in the LPL. They will fight you at random and weird places. Sometimes it works for them, sometimes it doesn't quite work out.
Let's contrast that then, shall we? Scrappiness can be complemented by team fighting when it hits late game. And speaking of,
they try to look for one here. They've got the magical journey to try and wrap around these three members of the newbie lineup, but a teleport is going to be used by V there just to deter away the Saint roster. Now Xu might actually be caught out here. Gets a good stun towards V. It's going to allow him to promptly escape from the collapsing members of newbie.
And with less than a minute till the dragon is available, the teleport was definitely worth completing for the Fizz. Mm-hmm. Does, however, look like they are looking towards the dragon above the turret. We'll see how they played out.
10 seconds until dragon number 3 does spawn here. Newbie look like they want to try and contest for this one. It is an ocean dragon, so no combat stats coming out from this Drake. Does seem like they want to try and take it down. They do get the risk on us, so they have control of the vision and movement over the pits. Instead, they're going to look towards the mid lane and try and shove that one out first.
Now just trying to run Saint around the map, and the battle continues. Of course, we have to keep our eyes on this Vladimir. He's starting to get unreasonably large, as is customary.
Yeah, he's got 30% cooldown reduction already with the Protobelt, Abyssal Scepter, and the Phoenix Codex being completed. And Newbie actually able to take down the third dragon of the game. So they get the Ocean Dragon. The next dragon to spawn will be another Ocean Dragon. So they would definitely want to try and fight for that one, try and snack them up.
Yeah, they almost forced recalls out of Saint and just kind of waltz in and take the Drake for themselves. There's two teleports.
Saint definitely looking for a deep flank here against V. He's going to be able to use the playful trickster to run away for now. Happy now. He's the one that gets caught out. STYZ is going to pick up the kill for himself. And V suddenly found two more members of Saint here looking towards taking him down. Acorn is so sticky on this Echo. He's able to lock the Fizz down for so long. Dashes forward. One more attack is going to be enough. He's going to pick it up. Marsh finds it with the Prey Seeker. And Saint find two more picks.
Yeah, the nice teleport. Very reactive play once again from this team. Dade is going to try his best to get an objective on the flip side, but don't be shocked if Saint just commit to the bottom lane and send Snoopy to 1v3 and never die.
He will be able to take down this mid lane outer turret and continue to split push here. But this
he's actually about to 1v3.
Too.
We'll see how this goes. Oh. Yeah.
Perhaps Snoopy's actually going to get jumped on here. Pops the bird form, is able to just flash away. That turret eventually falls down in both the mid lane and the bottom inner turret falls down for Saint. So they're four turrets to one. We're looking for a wraparound against the newbie lineup. He's actually going to be able to find more. Ankle's going to jump on top of him. Here comes Marsh as well. Slows him down with a chilling slide. STYZ shifts forward.
Whoa, too. Dade.
Dade's going to jump in aggressively with a protobell. Looking to try to take down an Echo. Ezreal, sorry. As a nice ultimate comes up from Bard to stop the Humo Plague popping from Dade there.
Yeah, tempering with that AD carry. Fade definitely keeping him alive there. Getting the bottom turret as well. It's a deep turret taken. Could make life easier when they look towards Baron, which at 26 minutes is always worth looking at.
Mm-hmm.
Having a Blade of the Ruined King rushed on STYZ is the AD carry choice. Doing a lot of damage. It means he'll also be shredding that percentage value that is a Baron's health bar.
I didn't think I'd be able to say this in this match, but Saints still in a very commanding lead at the moment. 6,000 gold ahead of newbie right now.
This is just weird.
It's 25 minutes into the game too, so this is, you know, laning phase over. This is normally where Saints starts to falter. And it really feels like they're making the correct map rotations right now. They've been picking up good picks here and there, converting it into small objects as well, taking their time with things. Just really want to see if they can keep this up to try and end the game here against newbie.
You have to wonder if March's addition to the jungling pool of their three rotating junglers actually makes a difference. Because at this stage, having that many players on your roster, you have to question who the shot caller is.
Yep.
If it's always the jungler, that's a lot of shot callers, right? And result, though, would indicate having March on the team makes them infinitely better.
And one thing that has stayed the same for the Saint lineup is they've been playing Snoopy over Otto quite significantly here.
And Acorn's always there. So That's the thing that I think we're looking at. Perhaps the bottom lane is the big difference, and they won their bottom lane quite handily, which then spills over into the rest of the map.
And this is a similar story to when they played against Invictus Gaming and picked up one win in that best of three series. STYZ picked up a very early lead on his Caitlyn, and then the bottom lane was able to move around the map, pick up objectives, and fight with the rest of the Saint lineup and add value and add power to the Saint lineup from the advantage they created for themselves early in the game. Seems like they're doing the same thing here against newbie.
That's right. We're starting to tell our own stories of what this team is capable of. March perhaps should just be looking at that bottom lane, get them going. That shot calling definitely improves when they have a lead. Hex Drinker as well for STYZ means that Vladimir is not going to be doing as much when it comes to the team fights with Burst. Very smart pickup as they both get out. Oh, nah, you're dead.
Field goal did miss, but another shot comes up from Shu. Didn't actually spot him out. He's going to be able to flash away.
Did they not see him walk out of the bush to dodge it? They mustn't have seen him. Interesting.
Still, Force of Flash coming out for more, so not going to be able to initiate fights or defend his carries that well, so to speak. And Swift now trying to do what he can to clear out vision towards the Baron Pit. Newbie's still hanging on in this game. They're not, you know, rolling over and giving up anytime soon.
I know they're absolutely hanging on, being quite resilient, as is expected, to be fair.
Mm-hmm. They do have a very strong Vladimir, who's already picked up his Zhonya's Hourglass here to complement his Protobelt and Abyssal Scepter. So it's a very deceptively tanky Vladimir, who will probably refuse to die.
Tanky. Just tanky. He's actually just a tank. Vladimir.
Just Vladimir things.
He identifies as a tank.
Let's see what impact Dardai can have. Towards the 30-minute mark of this game, the next dragon is going to be spawning in less than a minute. So newbie could definitely try to fight Saint over the dragon pit. Possibly try to take it to them early. And Zaycon's going to be a little bit of a nuisance here against V. Just chases him across Summoner's Rift.
Teleport's available. Swift caught.
He's going to get caught out. Forced to use his ultimate there. Trying to stay alive inside of the Ransom Spy. There's more using his ultimate to lock him down. But Acorn is able to pick up the first kill. Good ultimate coming out for Shu. Locks down so many members. Newbie, they're dropping like flies now. As Moore's the next to fall. V trying to stay alive. Not going to happen though. As there's another Stasis coming out from Dade. He's going to get taken down as well. Saints find three kills for themselves. They set their eyes towards Baron.
And you can't break that front line of Saint by any means at all. Newbie, they just blunder. And that should be the Baron taken. AD carries were duking it out. That's already unusual because STYZ is massive, whereas Happy is not. The end result, very big victory once more for our team that hasn't found a victory.
Mm-hmm.
In Saint.
When this Baron falls down, Saint will have a 9,000 gold lead. over the newbie lineup, and this is just starting to get out of control for newbie. We know they can fight from behind. We've seen them do it before, especially Spring Split when they're known as Chao Gu. This is looking like a little bit of a disaster right now.
I think the biggest gold deficit they came back from was 10,000, but it was definitely a lot later in the game than 30 minutes, I believe.
It was a hard-fought fight. They would have stalled that one.
This just doesn't feel like the same newbie. And it's been like this for a week now.
Yep. You know, it's not especially great for Saints either. They came off a very decisive loss, you could say. It's Snake.
They got
dumpstered. Yeah, we saw SFM just walk all over March. Oh, not March, sorry, Captain.
He did March all over Captain.
And they were very commanding in that victory. Snake definitely on the upward trend here in week three of the LPL. Saints, we kind of expected them to stay the same. Newbie, we didn't exactly quite know what was going to happen to them. Now, this game kind of sums it up. They've really been falling behind in the LPL so far.
We called it a struggle. I think it's just safe to say that it's a slump now. Even if they win this game, it's definitely still a slump.
Yeah, just things not looking good for Newbie. This is not how we would see them play in the Spring Split, not how we expected them to play, coming into Summer Split as well. As the third dragon we saw was taken down by Saints as well. So they pick up an Ocean Dragon for themselves. The next one to spawn will be the Elder Dragon. So no more Elementals on the map.
And a big point of power now to be established by the Saint roster. They haven't covered the top lane though, unfortunately. They're looking at two lanes only. So it's not holistic. They can't quickly rotate between the two. Of course, a sloppy but expected thing for a team like this. Naturally though, with the strength that they have, STYZ's poke, Snoopy still being able to convincingly win a 1v1 down here, you would imagine. Also, an Acorn being quite large with that Echo. They have a lot of zone control. They might be able to just push their way in and push Newbie off.
They're looking to try and do just that as Acorn dashes in towards his parallel convergence. Sewer pops down to Tebefe, locks down Swift there, has to use his ultimate. He's incredibly low. Doesn't look like he's going to get out of this one alive as Dade tries to chase down STYZ. Does have the Hemo playing on top of the enemy carry. It's able to take him down first in this fight. Newbie definitely trying to fight back as Swift somehow was able to live through all that burst.
A double kill off for
Dabe. He's looking for more. He's trying to dash in through. Here comes V now. They find Acorn. Snoopy now the next target here. Dade is still alive. Puts down even more tides of blood as Snoopy trying to do whatever he can to stay alive as the Birdman pops his own hourglass.
He's got no mana now.
Regenerates a lot of health. But can't do anything more as Dade finds a third kill for himself in his team fight. Newbie don't even lose a single member there.
Four big kills. May as well be five because March is just the tank of the team. And Newbie, why is it not surprising that we hit 30 minutes and they win a team fight when they're down by too much gold? Somehow they always do it. But this time around, the answer is Dade.
Whew.
Dade's always going to be the answer on this Vladimir. Going from strength to strength while the rest of his team is struggling.
He's going absolutely nuts here in this game. He's 6-2-2. On top of his core items, he's looking towards a Void Star for his next pickup. But Rusty, take us through this replay.
Yeah, so it actually kicks off quite nicely for Saint. Happy gets zoned and is only really hitting tanks. The Swain also coming through with the flank. Locks him down for an extended period of time. But look at Dade. He is so deep. STYZ is the primary damage source that has now been taken off the board. The rest of that team were tanks standing in front of him. And the big misplay was that they weren't standing in front of him. They didn't keep him alive, and the sustain as well as damage that comes out of Dade on this Vladimir more than enough to lock down the rest of this team fight. All it takes is to kill that carry. STYZ went down.
Didn't even take down the mid lane in the turret. During the fight, we're able to get it later on, but we can take a look at the damage dealt during the fight itself. Oh, Dade. Just doing Dade things, it seems.
Yeah, it's funny because STYZ did the second most damage to champions, but it was only on the Vladimir. And so it didn't look like he did any damage.
Nope.
It may as well say zero.
Dade will just heal up completely during that entire team fight.
Why are you glowing red, Acorn?
Because he can.
Why is he glowing red?
I don't know. That's what you're here for.
Server battle?
For now, though. Swift getting caught out one more time. I've seen this story quite a few times in this game. He's going to have to flash over the
Swift's
wall. Snoopy
dead.
Just follows him through. Saint find another pick here. It's not quite looking like Swift's game here today.
No, too deep for some reason there. Swift 147 right now is this Kindred. 0-5 bottom lane. All it is V and Dade against the world. One blunder of a team fight for Saint shows the good and bad of both of these teams in a single moment.
Yep.
But the bad just starts to shine through once again.
Saints still do have a good gold lead for themselves, so about 8,000 gold up. And Snibby's just going to be able to take down this turret with Acorn's health. They've broken through the base. Now V trying to defend against three people. We do have Happy moving down there. Trying to look to see what they can do against March now. The tank taking a lot of damage. Acorn dashes in towards the power converges. V, he's on top of March, who's able to take a tunnel to safety. Has to use the playful tricks to get out of there now. And there comes the Kurtzicor, looking to try and take down March in the back lines. And Acorn just going to soak up all of the pellets here. The final shot not going to connect with the Echo. They successfully defend the inhibitor. Still a turret loss for the newbie lineup.
Yeah, and the ult was never going to get anything that curtain call, because meanwhile, in the rest of the map, they are still trying to get things done. This is a point in the game where we know Saint have the advantage. We know they're looking to try and close a victory out.
Yep.
They finally break a turret. But with each little victory that they get, they're giving opportunities to newbie to claw back in themselves. And we know that of all teams in the LPL, they're the ones that can get it done.
And Dragon, or Elder Dragon, it says, I was about to say Dragon number 5. Elder Dragon and Baron are going to be spawning within the next 30 seconds here. So two major objectives on the map. Saint do have control over Summoner's Rift, so it could potentially take them down for themselves. Let's see if
they just, like, they just need Swift to show up.
Mm-hmm.
He just kind of left his brain at the door today. And once that arrives, it could just be a little bit delayed. It might be stuck in traffic. Then you'll find that newbie will be able to teamfight. A lot of magic resistance, honestly, stacked everywhere from Saint.
Yep.
Like, everywhere. They're not going to die to magic damage at all.
Physical damage going to be the main factor in these fights.
Which is why I say that. They need Swift. They need Happy to start showing up.
Well, SDYZ completed his mortal reminder, so that's going to, you know, make the healing coming up from Dade a little bit less. Even the Lamasus might heal a little bit less in these fights.
Yeah, and to be fair, the same side on Swift is working towards his. So, a single Q, I will say, by the way, onto Swift, half health him. Half health.
Good. It's a very farmed SDYZ. In fact, has 6 items up and running here. Blade of Rune King, more Mount Mortius.
He's pretty big.
Yep. Iceborne Gauntlet, Mirror Mana, fully stacked. Berserker Grease with the Mortal Reminder.
Even a GA as well for Acorn. I cannot see many ways into this.
Acorn, 6 items as well.
For newbie, yeah. This should be an easy Baron secure. Newbie will fight for it.
Uh-huh.
Just comes down to the execution.
Well, let's see if the execution is good enough, because you look at V. He's 2 items behind Acorn right now. Saving Grace, Dade, he's almost got 6 with the Void Staff, but you mentioned already, lots of magic resistance he has to go up against right now.
I mean, the actual Saving Grace is just the champions that newbie are playing.
Hello.
It's a very cheeky Baron, will be spotted.
Second out towards half health, is spotted out by the Trinket being placed down there.
They didn't see the health of the Baron, though.
It's going to be taking out really low SDYZ in March. Going to be able to complete this one, it feels. Newbie, they definitely want to try and contest with this one. They're towards the pit already. Snoopy trying to keep them occupied.
Nice ulti.
Good ultimate. Temper Fake going to lock down 3 members of Newbie. Dade trying to do what he can as Swift. He's in the back lines this time, not getting chunked out. Acorn trying to dash forward. Takes a lot of damage. Dade, he's on top of so many members. Able to get back on towards the Kindred ultimate. Everyone's getting taken out really low. Happy takes down Shoot. The training members left, right, and center. SDYZ has to flash away. Dade, where is he? He's still alive. Trying to keep track. Good Curtain Newbie coming out. Newbie find the fight for themselves. The double kill comes out from Happy there. Acorn still able to take them down, but they trade evenly. And they're still going to be able to push for themselves. Newbie somehow take them in that team fight.
About 10,000 gold once again. And Newbie still get a team fight that goes reasonably even. They don't get the Baron buff. Saint will still lock that one down. They'll still have Acorn and March standing with that buff. So a window of opportunity to try and push an advantage. But if newbie can hold, we've seen what they're capable of doing now.
And, you know, Saint not really going to get any stronger, but take us through this fight, Rusty.
It's Dade. That's what this fight is. She gets a nice ultimate and stuns Swift as well as more, so they kind of lock down the back line. Happy's doing a lot of damage, honestly, this early, but look at Dade. He's actually just chilling at the back, fighting 3 people and winning in terms of trades. And that's just the power of the Vladimir. Yes, he comes back to try and help the rest of his team. Happy kind of caught in a position he doesn't want to be in because they can see him ulting. And yes, it's a nice ultimate on the STYZ, but by killing him, he compromised his own position. That's where Acorn takes him down. And everything settles.
Still a massive team fight coming out from Newbie there. They're able to claw that one back slightly. Look at the damage dealt in that fight. Dade putting in some work. We criticize him, you know, the pickup of Dade, you know, replacing Doinbi for the Newbie lineup.
I think the only reason we questioned it is simply because Doinbi is a unique mid laner that worked for Newbie.
Yep.
By swapping him out to another mid laner, it takes a lot of time for adjustment or to actually get used to what is a completely different playstyle due to how unique Doinbi is. Dade's always been a fantastic mid laner. In fact, he is comparatively actually an upgrade. But it's just not, perhaps, for Newbie.
Gives us a little bit of time to check in with items as Elder Dragon has to be started by Saints, you know. Top laner, jungler, and AD carry for the Saints lineup have 6 items. Snoopy's still waiting to complete his final item, just sitting on a chain vest. You look at the side of Newbie, nobody has 6 items just yet, just components of their final item, but that's a lot different than it was in that final fight, so Saints are not really going to get any stronger. Newbie just have a lot more time to claw back into this if they want to.
This is clever from Snoopy as well. There's no one to respond to him. Newbie just has to recall as a team and give up the map presence they had. In fact, he might just be getting this before it dies. No.
Backs off.
Man up.
Swift being a little bit aggressive here towards March as STYZ going to flash in forward too. There's the curtain call being popped there by Happy. Gets a lot of shots down towards STYZ and March. Not
Why is he
anyone.
Not hitting it? Hit it.
Decides not to. Lets the minions do the work.
Hit the inhibitor.
Well, he's going back for it now. He should have been doing that previously. Snoopy now going to be able to take it down for himself. There it goes.
And now he's just deep because he didn't hit it earlier.
But Elder Dragon has been started there by the Saint lineup, so they're probably going to trade Snoopy's life for that one. He's going to get locked down. The birds are going to heal up quite a lot there. He tries to go towards the minions to heal up even more. Going to be able to stay alive for a little bit longer as V joins that fight, is able to take down Snoopy. Happy picks up the kill. This Elder That's Dragon, gone. Though, is going to fall in favor of Saint. But Newbie have a man advantage against Saints right now. Let's see what they can do with it.
But it's also 4 Elder Dragons on the... Sorry, 3 Drakes being buffed by that Elder Dragon.
Yep.
On the side of Saint. That is an unreasonably strong red team right now. If they look to a team fight, even with a numbers advantage, you would almost say that Saint have the edge. The funny thing is, the duration of that buff as well is not too long. Mm-hmm. They need to be careful here, Saint, because if they just take the buff for the sake of it, not fight with it, they're wasting it.
Well, it's already a quarter gone here. And by the time Snoopy gets back online, they might only have a quarter left of that buff.
Yeah. Big mistake.
So, let's see what they can do with it. For now, it looks like absolutely nothing as Newbie just trying to hold on here in game number 1 against Snake. Just trying to farm up wherever they possibly can, try to match the items that have been completed from the Saint lineup. So far, they've been doing that, but they've been hanging by a thread, Rusty. And Saint, once again, you know, looked great early. Good laning phase. Somehow transitioned into the mid game and looked well. And then things are just falling apart when it comes to actually killing the Nexus.
The wheels are falling off right now. They're wobbly. They definitely need to try and get it together. Tighten it up. Make sure that they can secure this, because you're right, like, this is taking far too long given how the lead was, given what the lead is. And yes, Newbie is starting to get to a point where they have items themselves, but still no Last Whisper available for the Jhin.
It's a bit scary.
He shouldn't be able to kill these tanks.
He's sitting
There's
on
no damage.
5 items right now. Dade has his 6th item completed, which is the Rabadon's Death Cap. True Shot Barrage went the wrong way there from STYZ. No one saw that, don't worry.
What True Shot Barrage? I didn't see anything. This is the last-ditch attempt, honestly, from Newbie. There is still that Elder buff. Oh, we're doing a lot of damage, Saint, but not for too much longer.
Yep, that buff actually going to be expiring in just a second, you would believe. Can't quite see how long it's got left.
It's gone.
There it is, gone.
And
now.
Look at the fight straight after.
They're looking for it. Acorn actually taking a lot of damage. Swift jumping in towards the front lines. Parallel Convergence not going to get used. That's his Guardian Angel going to get propped very shortly as he uses the ultimate. Tempered Fate only locks down Dade, though. Here comes Acorn getting back up and alive. Has to flash away immediately. Magical Journey trying
they
to get the
same
members to safety. Snoopy going to take it down here. Guardian Angel pop from the mid lane as well as Dade takes down Acorn. And backlines Snoopy. How do you do this? Coming back one more time here. Flash comes out, but it might not be enough. As Happy gonna flash over as well. Takes down the Swain and Newbie. They're back into the game one more time here. They pick up a fight. Swift is trying to fight STYZ. Uses his ultimate. Dade gonna try and join him. Does get locked down by Shield. STYZ still looking to be a little bit aggressive here as Newbie tags him with the transfusion over the wall. But Newbie Another team fight in their favor.
He's about to have his ultimate, so we'll see if he can actually be cheeky and connect that one. But Newbie, hold the fort once more. Honestly, late game team fighting is their strength. They excel at this. But Saint also just suck at this, plain and simple. They cannot end this game if their life depended on it right now. And it's a Vladimir against a Swain. And you have to say, we've hit late game. That Vladimir is starting to outscale.
Look, 6 items completed on everybody from Saint. They're not getting any stronger. We said this before when the past few fights at Newbie were winning. Newbie didn't even have their 6 items on most of their members. They still don't, and they're winning
deep.
Team fights.
You're way too deep, Braum.
More, what are you doing, my friend?
This is not the side of the map you want to be on.
This is not the fight you were looking for, Braum. He puts down the shield, tries to stay alive.
Where is he?
Swift is actually coming in here. Here's some teleports coming here too. Everyone's teleporting in. Shield, he's getting taken down. Snoopy now caught between a rock and a hard place.
Oh,
as he
my
gets
God.
A double kill on over towards Swift. Here comes the curtain call. Newbie, they're looking for this fight. 3-on-5 now. Dada is in amongst it. Acorn tries to lock it down. The power convergence not going to be enough.
They've got this.
Finds that kill for himself. Newbie, they find 3 picks against the Saint lineup, which was looking like more going on a little bit of a journey.
Yeah, that's a lot of damage from Swift as well to back that one up. A miracle from March is exactly what they'll need right now on this Baron.
A miracle and then some, I feel. Has to come out from the Saint lineup to try and stop this.
Here he goes.
This was their game to win. He's going to go into
March.
The pit.
Just
they're looking
March.
To just kill him. Swift ignores the Baron. Smites are coming out. Not going to matter. Swift picks up the kill. And this is a 47-minute Baron buff for a Newbie. And there's still 6,000 gold behind. It doesn't matter. They're just going to end the game.
But the gold's irrelevant at this point in the game because they've hit the 80k gold mark and they've got their items. What was a great early game from Saint has now just completely backfired into an even late game. Gold's irrelevant. All that matters is how your team works together when they fight. And Newbie just always have that execution factor there. They do everything as a team, hit or miss. And they are just leaps and bounds above Saint right now.
They certainly are. They're showing that in the late game. It was a big fumble from the Newbie lineup very early on. We thought, you know, I thought especially, this is going to be Saint's game to win. It has to be.
This is Saint's game to win.
It still
they
is.
Lose this game. They just made a mistake. They were 11,000 gold up.
You know, Newbie are now punishing Saint for what IG couldn't punish them for. It really feels like that's what's happening this game.
As far as defeats go as well, like if Saint lose this, that is the single most demoralizing thing that you would ever experience. Whew. You go back, you watch those VODs, and you just tilt. Like, tilt into a full 360 and become a good team again.
You know, Saint go home tonight. Coach says, no internet. Turn it off. Not allowed to watch anything that happened during game number one here.
But with this Baron buff as well, Newbie, they still haven't won the game. They are still behind 5,000 gold. And they need to try and break what is the base of Saint, because that thing is standing strong. There are outer turrets somewhere in the bottom lane. There's inner turrets everywhere. Newbie can't do it themselves. Now we've got this really weird stalemate.
You can actually see STYZ. He's sold his boots on Ezreal to pick up a Bloodthirster. And this, no, it's an AD carry that doesn't go for crit.
He is so slow.
He
oh
just
my god, he's slow.
Walks at a snail pace right now.
He's actually so slow.
No.
Like, if Fizz looks at you the wrong way, you're probably going to start breaking down and cry.
Oh no, STYZ. You know,
we see
AD carries with lots of crits do this, not Ezreal's.
Oh, that's amazing.
For
I'm coming for you. I'm still coming for you. I'll be there in a. Oh, Jin's ulted. What the heck?
Looking to slow him down even further, it seems, as Snoopy takes the brunt of that damage.
Got him.
Yeah. Doesn't do quite much, though.
That's a lot of cannons, though. I feel like Newbie are just keeping them mid. They do need to go bottom right now. Like, that wave is starting to stack up massive.
These two top lanes just no longer take damage,
though. V should be recoiling.
That's a lot of damage down towards Snoopy one more time here. Gets the Swain towards half health. Grievous Rune stopping him from healing up there. As the middle inner turret falls for Newbie.
They've got a window of about a minute.
Yeah,
right,
you take a look at bottom lane, as you point out there, RC. Big wave pushing for the Saint lineup. Inhibitor has respawned for Newbie, though, so that will be able to soak up some of this wave.
Yeah, not enough. But we're 50 minutes in, so if they die and Saint get a teleport opportunity, it'll be game over.
Yep.
So they need to show some respect to this. Recall, use that Baron and power buff, and actually defend the Inhibitor. We said they had about a minute, and look how fast they are trying to run away.
Doesn't spot them out. They might be able to get a cheeky recall. Oh, no, parallel convergence top of everyone, but they're looking for the finest set. V trying to jump in there.
They still need V to recall and deal with these minions.
Oh, he's actually going to get locked down here. He's caught. Kurtzicol going to put out one more time. Playful Trickster does come out from the fist, trying to run away. That's a huge wave that's crashing in. There goes the parallel convergence. Sorry, the Temper Fate actually come out for shield, trying to lock them down. Swift, is he going to be able to get the recall?
Yes,
he does. He gets out of there. Now, Newbie just have to run for the hills. I don't think STYZ is going to be able to catch them up, let alone the rest of the team. Magical Journey does come out from shield and still looking to try to cunt them down. Moore is going to be able to put up the shield and stop.
They get out.
Stop the Q coming out from bar. They do get out. That was a hillbilly chase coming in there.
Crisis averted, honestly, from Newbie. They get to keep their inhibitor in the bottom lane. They establish themselves some more control on this map. They just want to keep Swain, honestly. Build up a stack of minions in that bottom lane. And put the Fizz there. He's got his Trinity Force as well. This man is full of items and ready to fight. This is such a disastrous game for Saint. You have to feel for them.
They're still ahead as well, which is even more of a disaster. We know it doesn't matter because everybody has six items, even the supports. You know, QSS on Seal right now. He's looking to carry a little bit. That will probably be upgraded to a Scimitar sometime soon.
It's like a blindfolded man on an Easter egg hunt. That's Saint right now.
That's good.
Don't ask where that came from either.
No, I don't. Baron Powerplay comes out as well for the newbie lineup. I don't think the gold really matters. We talked about that quite extensively. So what's Saint looking to do? Because they try to brute force.
They need a pick.
They need to find a pick.
Yeah, they have no room to work with. They have no vision to work with. They need a pick. And Swift looks like the option.
They try to find him. Ultimate actually gets put down by the
Kindred. That's actually big.
Stays alive. But he's going to get taken down. Acorn looking to try and jump on. It takes him. Saint find the pick here. Might be just what they need is more now. Trying to run away. Snoopy in the back lines already. Happy trying to run away as well. Dade uses the pull to
this
try and get
fight.
Out of this. Snoopy getting a lockdown here. Takes a lot of damage. Acorn trying to find his way into the back line. Does have Guardian Angel back up and available. They're not going to be able to find anyone else, but they still picked off Swift.
And they have a long time with Swift dead. It is going to be a 4v5. Acorn has his teleport, so he'll come back. And here comes the pressure.
Newbie have to do something right now. It's March. Takes a little bit of damage here. We can already see SCYZ. He's so
slow. Doing it.
He's trying to run away. SCYZ takes a lot of damage. Has to flash away. Human Play gets it down towards half his health. March now trying to run. V, he's on top of the AD carry. SCYZ shifts over towards Happy. Just puts a bullet to his face. And 4v5, Newbie don't care. They're looking for this fight. Magical Journey gonna let Newbie close in the gap towards Acorn and Shield, who are trying to run away. V puts down the fish. Chum the waters on top of the bar. Locks him down. Use the magical ability to try and jump away. Playful Tricks and slows him down. Acorn is going to be able to prop the Guardian Angel coming up from V there, but they still trade it one for one.
And they just needed, they just needed Happy to be there. It would have actually secured them the kills, but he was not in range. And honestly, the decision to sell your boots and go for a Bloodthirster has lost Saint the game at this point. The game is not over. Absolutely not. But they did that without Swift. And they have now got their fifth member spawned. The Elder Dragon has started. And Saint, they're not nearby anytime soon. They will get here if they choose to fight it. We'll see how they play this one out.
Well, they are rushing towards it now. Look at the damage dealt in
that
last
fight. It goes
without
saying at this stage.
Oh, that is rather disgusting coming out from Dade. 11,000 damage in one fight.
Swain is the poor man's Vladimir when it comes to late game team fighting. They feel very similar purposes. But one just does it outright better in the end. Dade, of course, a fantastic mid laner in his own right. And now, we're at 55 minutes.
Swift, he's going to be moving towards the Baron Pit now. So it's the rest of the newbie lineup. You'd have to think Saint wants to fight for it. They have all the members up and alive. Steel comes out from Snoopy there. Going to have a blue buff for himself.
Finally, the bottom outer dies.
Only 55 minutes into the game. Probably the longest bottom outer to ever fall.
They just need Fizz to be with the team a lot. That's kind of the problem. Is he splitting in lanes where he's defusing a Saint push.
Trying to see if any items have changed here ever since the pickup. Well, we can already see Sewell. He sold
that
QSS.
Yes, he has boots again. STYZ put his brain back in.
I got rid of that Bloodthirster. Okay. He wants to move around now.
I just don't understand that decision.
Shield's got the Mikhail's Crucible, so going to be able to remove the crowd control from one of his teammates. His Baron is now being started
it's
by Newbie.
It's getting destroyed.
It's at half health already. They've only just started it a couple of seconds ago. Tempered Fate
nice.
Actually going to come out. Good flank coming in from the Saint lineup, trying to teleport behind. Snoopy's getting into the back lines, but so is Dade. Now V, a little bit low.
Big ult from Dade.
Trying to jump on top of that. Good ult from Dade. It's March and Acorn now on the front lines. Gets taken down. Pops both their guardians. Angel, STYZ, he's fallen. Newbie just going to clean up this fight now without the any carry alive. Nami takes down the Rek'Sai, and that's a 4-kill coming out from Newbie. They look towards taking down Snoopy as well. They don't really care. They just move towards the base.
They have like 60 seconds remaining on the clock. There is zero opportunity for this Swain to do anything about this. He is a 1v5 army right now, and that's the problem. 1v5. Nobody died from Newbie in that last team fight. That's disgustingly strong from this late game team, Newbie. That's got to be the game.
56 minutes into game one here against Saint, and Newbie finally have the gold lead, and they're able to move in towards the Nexus. They take down the first Nexus turret. They're going to be able to take down Snoopy as well as soon as that Guardian Angel comes back online. And as I say, take him down. They look towards the Nexus as well. Curtain call just to add a little bit of flavor. And Newbie fight, and they hold on and pick up the win.
That took a long time to determine the winner of game number one in this best of three series. Saint showed a lot of positive signs, and they can reinforce themselves nicely. They just need to get from A to B. And they were close. They were so close to finding a victory.
And it's Saint one more time. Early laning phase, look great. STYZ finds a pick for himself one more time in the very early laning phase and gets ahead through it too. It's just closing out the game, Rusty. Saint just don't understand to win a game of League of Legends, you need to kill the Nexus, not lane really well.
That's just, how can you not win with an 11,000 gold lead? I mean, it speaks to the positives and the negatives of both of these teams, right? Struggling in the early game, that is Newbie. Whereas late game team fighting, that is their strength. Struggling in the late game is definitely Saint, whereas early game, they have what it takes to at least give it to the better teams in the LPL. A lot of blunders in these team fights mechanically, but also at the end of the day, Dade is just a thing on Summoner's Rift.
He kept them in this game for far too long. Off the back of Dade, he was able to, you know, stay alive, deal with the backline, impressively take down STYZ as well. He's on another level, Dade. I mean, he's not quite Doimi, not quite what they, you know, had during the splitting split, but he's still doing work here for Newbie.
As far as game one is concerned, Dade's absolutely on another level. Feels like Swift, time and again, kept getting caught out. Happy and more, they definitely struggled during that laning phase. But Newbie, late game team fighting, they are on another level.
They certainly were, and you know, that's something I really want to touch on as well. Swift kept getting caught out. There was a moment where it looked like Saint was just going to win the game after Newbie's valiant effort because he just got picked off one more time. Somehow Newbie able to win a fight 4v5 50 minutes into the game. That's something you don't normally see.
Yeah, I think the end result, we look at this, we say that if Dade was on anything other than the Vladimir, probably just a loss.
And you know, that's a huge, because that's a pick we saw. Vladimir, Swain, we thought which team's going to pick up which, and we saw the matchup, Dade coming out strong. It really is pretty much the saving grace for the Newbie lineup, you have to say.
Yeah, I don't think there's a better way to explain it right now. He is absolutely the saving grace. We'll see how they actually change that coming into game number two, to be fair, because they can definitely see where things went wrong. And it was blatantly obvious that they just struggled through laning phase. Perhaps Newbie's response is now just to pick better laning champions and give it to Saint properly.
Well, let's see if Newbie do change up anything coming into game number two. We're going to go into a quick break. We'll be back with game two between Saint and Newbie. Don't go anywhere.